to say that there was bad blood and hard feelings between Nineveh and Israel is a gross understatement. So when God came to Jonah and told him to go to Nineveh and preach repentance, otherwise he would destroy them, well, to put it in modern terms, imagine if God told a cougar from Wazoo and a husky from the UW to preach repentance to each other. Yeah, it didn't go over very well. Jonah's first instinct was to run. And the best way to run a long distance in those days was on board a ship. So he went to the port of Joppa and he looked along at the ships there in harbor and he figured the one that was going to get him the furthest, the fastest, was one that was going clear across the Mediterranean to Tarshish. So he paid his fare, he mumbled something about running away from God when they asked where he was going, and he climbed down to the hold of the ship, curled up in a corner, and was soon fast asleep. Now, if Jonah had read his Psalms, he would have known that there is no place you can go to run away from God. God knew exactly where Jonah was, and God sent a terrible storm to besiege that ship. Now, the sailors on that ship were all experienced men. They knew what to do in bad weather, but this particular storm, they'd never seen anything like it. They struggled to keep their boat afloat. They even jettisoned some of the cargo, hoping to keep it up and not let it sink. And finally, in desperation, they all started praying, each man to their own god, but it didn't seem to be helping anything. And finally, the captain remembered there was that man down in the hold, and he went and woke up Jonah. He said, "Hey, you, this is no time for sleeping. All hands on deck. You're praying to your God along with the rest of us. Let's see if that helps." So Jonah came up on deck, and he added his prayers to the sailors' prayers, but it didn't help at all. The storm kept worsening. And finally, the sailors, in desperation, well, they started casting lots, trying to see if they could figure out where this malady was coming from. And they cast the lots, and everything showed very clearly. There was one person to blame. That was Jonah. And they looked at him and said, "All right, who are you? Where are you from? And why has this storm beset us?" And he said, "Well, he was from Israel. He was a Hebrew. They worshiped the God who created the heavens and the earth and the seas." And they said, "Wait a second. You worship a God that you say created the seas, but you're running away from him on board our ship on the seas, and you're putting us all in danger? Okay, how are we going to fix this?" Jonah thought, and he said, well, he thought the best thing they could do was to fling him overboard. Well, the sailors weren't quite ready to do that. They went again to their oars and they tried to pull the boat to shore, but to no avail. The storm kept getting worse and worse. And finally they grabbed Jonah and looked up and saying, "Oh God of Israel and Jonah, please do not put this innocent man's blood on our hands. Do not blame us for killing him. Please do not kill us. But after all, it was your pleasure to send him on this ship and send us this storm." And they threw him into the water. Instantly, the storm stopped. Well, the sailors were no fools. They fell to their knees and they started worshiping God and said that they would spend the rest of their lives doing that. As for Jonah, I'm sure that he felt that he would drown pretty quickly, but God had other ideas now, didn't he? He sent a huge fish that swallowed Jonah in one gulp. Now, maybe you, like many of us, have said, "Oh God, yes, I would spend more time in prayer with you if only I had more time for quiet time." Gotta watch out for prayers like that, because this is how God answered Jonah. 3 days and nights of quiet time in a belly of a fish. And Jonah's prayers went kind of like this: "Oh God, I am in the pits, but well, it looks like you're pulling me up, and all right, Lord, you rescued me, and okay, I'll keep my promises." And round about then, God directed the fish to spit Jonah out right there on the beach. Now, this next scene isn't in scripture, but I just can't help but imagining. The sun is rising. The fisherman and his family are walking along the beach, and they see something there kind of crawling out of the waves, and they get closer and realize it's a man, and he's reeking of fish guts, and he's barely conscious, and they go up and say, "Sir, sir, how can we help you?" And he lifts his face from the sand and said, "Nineveh, get me to Nineveh.